right, but it's heavy like my Jesus. My right will throw back like I'm fat, this shit too. For me, baby, I got deadly in my suit. She text me where you at, I send her how you come to. Now she in love with me, cause she ain't used to luxury. Why would I hate on you, I do my thing publicly. I'm not the one, I'm not the two, you know it's secretly. She rushing on my ways, talking about she need me.
Yeah, word. Lil' Giles, what's up, Lil' Giles? Oh, Lord, Will.
Essex girls basketball remains undefeated, and can they make it and make a run at the big dance? Showtime MMA Academy went 2-0 at the World Fighting Championships, and Lancaster basketball continues their dominance. Good evening, everyone. Get your popcorn ready. It's episode 49. You know what next week is then. Welcome in to No Next Sports Talk Live here on Hot Mix VA on a beautiful, cool Thursday night. I'm Will Lewis along with Coach Thomas Roane. Sammy is on a mission tonight, Coach. But first and foremost, happy Black History Month to all of you tonight. So, Coach, what you been up to last couple weeks?
Last couple weeks, man, just basically fighting with 2024, basically. You know, yeah. 2024 came in swinging and everything like that. You know, just regular life stuff, man. You know, you can't avoid life stuff, basically.
Right. Oh, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Especially when you got kids and everything. You know, even though they get older and out of your house and all that stuff, I mean, you still got to be the father.
I was trying to get you to come skating with us.
Man, you trying to get me to break my damn leg or something, man. I gotta get up and drive a damn truck at 1 o'clock in the morning and stuff. But no, but for real, my wife been talking about it. I think I might want to try to do a little surprise thing. Her birthday coming school.
Yeah, soon, why not?
And she been talking about skating and everything. So I don't know. I might take you up on that.
Yeah,
you know
what I'm saying? Come on.
Stand, they open on Sundays and stuff. Oh, all that stuff.
Too far.
So yeah, I might end up taking you up on that. I might surprise her or something. Yeah. Go over there, you know, do some little skating and stuff. I'm not going to do too much though, because I got to go to work. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, man, you know, just chilling, enjoying the basketball scene right
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
Even if I can't be able to make it to the games personally, you know, everybody that's doing them live feed, salute to y'all.
Yes.
Y'all
thank you so much,
clutch, man. Y'all be really be coming in the clutch and everything, because a brother got to get up early in the morning. And I can't make them games like that, man. You know, well, especially during the week.
Not on a school week.
Yeah,
not on a school night when you have homework.
Yeah.
And it's not your teenagers doing your homework. It's parents doing the homework. Because,
yeah.
Dad, what is this?
I know that's right, man.
I've been seeing algebra that I've never seen before.
Well, you know, they do that whole thing way different than everything now. We ain't do it back
exactly.
in the day. I mean, some of the ways that they do this math and all that stuff now, I'm like, how the hell are they? They current this
right thing. Yeah.
Back in the day, you know, we just put them up there and
yep.
subtraction or multiply
yep.
and that's it.
It's simple.
Now, man, shoot, I gotta go on YouTube and learn it my damn self before I even try to help my daughter.
I tell you, you got some brand new apparel on.
Yes, sir.
No Next Sports Talk Live apparel.
Yes,
look at that. That was awesome.
Shout out to my homeboy Charles Mitchell, aka Dude Lumpkin, aka
Dude
Charles,
yes.
aka Chuck. If you from Essex County, Tappahannock, Northern Virginia, y'all know who he is, man. Today, clothing. Look online, man. He can do whatever you want. He got his own clothing brand called Today Clothing. But if you got your own logo and everything like that, man, he can print that
yes,
up for
he
you,
can.
Too, man. So, you know, he got me this good jumper suit,
awesome.
The shirt, and the pants, and everything
looks
like
good.
That to represent the brand and everything like that. So, salute to my homeboy, Charles Mitchell, aka Baby Charles and everything, man. Salute on that.
All right, Coach, let's get to down to business,
yes,
so
sir.
To speak.
Yes, sir.
Virginia High School League Boys Class 1 top 10 scores from January 30th. This was this past week.
Yeah.
So, first of all, number one, George Wythe over Grayson, 70-18. George Wythe is continuing to roll like Lancaster. Lancaster of Westmoreland, 58-41. Mm-hmm. That was on the 30th.
Yeah.
Also, Carver Academy, 110-47 over Matthews. 110-47 over Matthews. Carver Academy is a powerhouse.
And Carver Academy, they're like 13-1 right
they're
now.
They're 13-1, yeah.
So, I mean, you know, from what I've been seeing in the Class 1 in Virginia, man, you know, it's it's still a lot. There's a lot of talented teams out there. Man, you got Carver Academy at 13-1. Like you say, they just won, beat Matthews 110-47. That's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild.
You know, and not
really
just
wild.
Them. You know, Lancaster's 15-2. George Whip, they're what, 14-4. Alta Vista, they're 14-3. Mm-hmm. Now 17-1.
Yep.
So once you get down to that, you know, to the big games and that, it's going to be a lot of going back and forth with them boys, man. And but I'm still riding with them Lancaster Red Devils coming out.
I think so too. Yeah, Lancaster, I'm seeing them going back to the state championship this spring.
Yeah.
Probably facing George Whip.
Hey, well, we definitely hope they keep on and keep continuing how they're doing, man. Because, I mean, the program is definitely putting the North
definitely.
On the map as far as with boys basketball. I mean, but again, as far as within the district and everything, I mean, Northumberland is right there still.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. Northumberland is 9-5. They're 4-2 in the district. Westmoreland 6-6.
They're
5-2 in the district. I think they're number two. So it's still a lot of tough games in the district.
Yeah,
I mean, they still got like, what, two more games?
Two more games before
get to the tournament
district tournament and then regionals.
So I mean, you know,
it's getting close.
It's getting close, man.
All right, a couple more. Honaker of Patrick Henry, 60-29. Honaker's not ranked. Patrick Henry is ranked at number 9.
Okay.
This past Wednesday night, Colonial Beach over Rappahannock. That was last night. Colonial Beach over Rappahannock, 51-45. Couple of JV scores. A couple messages I got saying, can you please shout out the JV scores? So we're doing that.
Salute, Travis. I got
47-29 Rappahannock JV boys over Westmoreland JV boys. Varsity boys, Westmoreland over Rappahannock 61-24 from Wednesday night. So also congratulations to the Rappahannock Middle School boys basketball team. Finished the season with a record of 12-1 and scoring their completion of 605-293. So great job. With Rappahannock Middle School.
Dang, and last year was the Eagles.
It was Westmoreland.
Yeah, they took it all in.
And I don't know their record yet because I didn't get any information from Montrose Middle School as to what their record is this year. But they were still doing pretty well. I don't think they ran the table this year, but they were still doing pretty well.
Well, I mean, at the end of the day, I like that all of the schools now have the middle school programs. You know, that's just the middle school program. Man, our boys been doing real good on the field, I mean, on the basketball court and everything. So, I know if Sam was here, one of his big things was like, well, what y'all boys doing? It don't matter right now. We got the program.
On honor, Sam, I brought the Eagles shirt out.
Oh, man, whatever. But, hey, salute to y'all. You know what I'm saying? Y'all doing y'all thing. You know, and our boys basketball team, they need to pick it up.
Yes,
it's been
they
a
do.
Couple more weeks, you know what I'm saying, for them to be able to upset a couple boys.
Right. They've been fighting, but they've been fighting the good fight.
Yeah.
I mean, they've overcome some adversity during the season, but they're at number two in the district. So they're still 5-2. 5-2, what, in the district. 6-6 overall.
Yeah.
They're still there. They're still right there knocking on the door.
And, I mean, y'all got a senior over there that went bonkers the other day.
Yes, he did.
Against the Colonial
Beach.
Yes,
he did.
We're going to definitely shout you out a little later, young man. But he went bonkers the other day.
Yes, he did.
I mean, again, like I say, all of the programs are doing real good. Like I said, I'm glad to see that all of the middle schools have programs now. So that's ain't going to do nothing to make the basketball competition around here that much better in the future.
Right.
So, I mean, it's all up to the kids. Pay attention to the coaches. Pay attention to the schemes that they're drawing up, and only thing the coach can do is coach. The kids got to be the ones on the basketball court doing what they got to do to win.
And then you got Colonial Beach, overall 8-8, right at 500. I mean, they may be 2-5 in the region, but they're right at 500. So they have been somewhat making some noise this year.
Yeah, only ones that been making my noise really is my boys on this side, man. But we're gonna get it together, man.
But your girls is undefeated.
Oh yeah, them girls, man. Them girls putting
they are undefeated. They're putting boots to necks.
Yes, sir. They play tonight, so hopefully they, you know, well, we ain't got to them yet, but hopefully they can finish the season on out before they get into the tournament play.
So you have some highlights for the boys before we get to the girls basketball side, right?
Well, I mean, you know, Lancaster, as you said, they've been on a tear lately. You know, even though they lost two games this season, The only two games that they lost was mainly to teams that wasn't even.
And in they the were those were tournaments.
In the tournaments, and I think they were bigger teams.
Yeah.
You know, you figure the last two games that Essex played, they played Essex on January 29th. Uh-huh. They beat us 63-26. Uh-huh. And I mean, shoot, first quarter they put up 24 points in the first quarter. We ain't put up nothing but 1 point. You know what I'm saying?
So that's from, a football score.
Yeah. So from what I see with Lancaster, man, they jump out big on you in the first yeah. the first half.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The second half of the games or whatever, they usually slack back, you know, and take a chill pill. But if you don't jump on them in the first two quarters, man, you in for a ball game. You know, yeah. like I said, they jumped up 24-1 on Essex in the first quarter. The second quarter, they put up another 13 points to only our six. So we went into the half, what, 37-7?
Yeah.
Ain't no way you can come back from a score like that, you know. And I mean, it's somebody look at the coaches as on our end that they're not doing anything. But everybody know over here we're a football team, you know. But we have basketball players, so I'm real shocked that y'all ain't getting it together just yet. But I'm gonna keep rolling with y'all. Hopefully, over the next 2 weeks, y'all gonna be able to pull something out y'all hat. But Lancaster is just. They're just a monster right now.
Yeah, they are.
You know, they're continuing off of where they left last year, and I don't see them stopping. You figure on that game, Troy Henderson, which I thought he was a senior this year.
Yeah.
But he's only he's a junior.
He's a junior. That's right. He's a junior.
One more year left to go high school basketball, man. And I mean, I
think the coach over sent me
his best. We'll go over later, but I think that man's close. Close to almost 2,000 points.
Yeah.
You know, I think he's like at 16-something, and we still got the rest of the season to go. And he still has a whole another year of basketball to go. You know, so I believe he's on the verge of breaking the school record over there in Langston. Ooh. He put up 30 points when he played us on January 20th.
He already broke it.
He already broke the school record. So by the time he's gonna set that point average up so high that whoever the next man that come out and try to break that, you're going to have to
be. And he should be in Class 1 All-State.
Yeah. Oh,
okay. He should be.
That's no
brainer there.
That's no
coach.
Question, man. But, I mean, like I said, he put up 30 points against us. Not just with the points. He also grabbed 6 rebounds.
Right.
He gave up 3 assists. He had 6 steals. And, I mean, he just dominated, man. You know
yes,
what
he did.
I think little young soldier Lamar Maddox over there put up
14 still
points,
going
6 rebounds. Then you had senior Davion Smith. He's still helping on the boards, 4 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists. And he had 9 steals the other day against us. So, I mean, it's not just Troy. It's the whole squad.
It's the whole squad.
The whole culture squad.
Still rolling.
They're still rolling. They're a tight-knit team over there, and they're playing off of each other. Nobody, even though Troy is the top name that everybody sees, but the whole team is putting up points.
Yeah,
and they're
they
playing
are.
Together as a team of one. And that's what you need. That's what you need in a team to be able to go further in states and being able to win another state championship.
Yeah.
Then when you look at it, when you said they played Langston, I mean, they played Westmoreland on the 30th.
Uh-huh.
I mean, they beat Langston. Grinding together, the team can only get better
as
the time goes on and everything. So I mean, I'm real proud to see what they're doing over there, what
definitely.
The coaches are continuing to do over there. Because I mean, it isn't easy.
It's not easy at all.
Off of a season like they had last year, with going, they went undefeated last year, coming back around this year, being able to go 15-2, and not just being 15-2. But the only two losses that you lost was two teams that was in a tournament.
Right, yeah.
And they most likely was a bigger class team than you.
Yeah, one was out of state.
You know what I'm saying? So eventually, in my eyes, for real, as far as class.
4A
team. So in my eyes, when you're talking about Lancaster Red, that was my, in my eyes, they still undefeated me. Because they haven't lost to a Class 1 team in Virginia yet.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The two losses they took was the teams in the bigger divisions than them. Uh-huh. So Hey, man, I don't see nobody stopping them.
And the main thing this year is that they learned to have a lot more patience on that court.
Yeah.
From the videos I've seen, even with the Westmoreland game, it might have been a little bit lower scoring game than they wanted to be, but they got patience.
Yeah.
They were able to learn a lot of patience with that game, and the result was a win.
Yeah, it definitely was. So, I mean, only thing I can say, the coaches over there keep on doing what you're doing. And, I mean, we'll definitely look to see them at where they hold the states at for basketball.
Single Center at VCU.
VCU. We're definitely looking to see y'all at VCU because we're definitely going to be in the building if they make it there.
Definitely, definitely. Oh, yeah, guys, don't forget to call in tonight. Yes, call in. Talk to us. Shine the light on your favorite player, coach, host, whatever.
Yeah.
804-822-2837. 804-822-2837. Call in. Make sure you guys call in. Say hi to us. Shine the light on your favorite player, coach, basketball team, football team, what have you. Shine the light.
Yes, sir.
Shine the light. All right, let's get to the girls' basketball, coach. Girls' basketball from the 30th. Westmoreland over Lancaster, 62-28. Rappahannock over Colonial Beach, 39-33. Pretty close game. King William over West Point, 54-48. Matthews over Carver Academy, 33-28. St. Margaret's. We can't talk enough about St. Margaret's. St. Margaret's over Richmond Warhawks, 71-26. They may be losing games here or there, but they still are rocking and rolling in their division too. So we're still keeping an eye on St. Margaret's as to how far and how deep they're going to go in the playoffs in their division, because they're just smoking teams out, on exception of one or two losses here and there, but still strong girls team.
I mean, with St. Margaret's, man, you gotta realize with them, we usually don't talk about them that much because basically they're not getting promoted. They're getting promoted like how they're getting promoted now. You know, with Tina Fauntleroy, Travis's wife, and everything, and with the coaches, though, they're really promoting the program and trying to
build
something for the private school that's in this area. You know, St. Margaret's usually gets a lot of kids that's not in this area. I think we got a couple kids in the area that goes there, but a lot of their kids come from different parts of America, you know, coming here for private school. I think I know they're part of the Visa, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever, it's the private school and everything like that. So the competition that they face is a lot more tougher than the regular school programs and everything. But the good thing about St. Margaret, the connection that the coaches have with a lot of the local schools, during the off season they play each other.
Right. Yeah.
So the local schools like Essex girls, they was facing them this year doing scrimmages, and not only that, during the off season. Some of the Essex girls and St. Margaret's girls was on travel, AAU type teams or whatever. So a lot of the girls are able to feed off of the St. Margaret's program, and the St. Margaret program is able to feed off the Essex program and stuff like that about working together and everything. So, I mean, Tina and them have the program going in a forward motion, if I can say so. You know what I'm saying? It's way different from the past. They're starting to get a whole lot more people locally coming out to support the basketball team at St. Margaret. So I'm real satisfied to see what they're doing over there, because eventually that's going to be the more kids and families that's
going
to want to be able to transfer that to that program too, you know. And it'll be not just one, but two or three strong programs in the area that's going to be able to benefit the kids around.
And they had a definite strong field hockey program back in the fall too. So Essex and Northumberland, Essex wins that game per forfeit.
Yeah.
But Essex, 14-0 right now, coach.
Yeah.
And they're looking, from what I can tell, looking to make a run to the state championship.
Only thing I can say about those Essex Lady Trojans basketball team, they've done a phenomenal job.
Yes, they did. My goodness.
And I mean, they came a long way from the pandemic era.
Yeah.
You know, and I mean, what I mean by that, they didn't get to play during that, I think it was 2020 season or something, when COVID kicked off and all that stuff, so they had to miss a season and everything. And they came back that following season when everything started opening back up, and Coach Jonathan Mercer took over the team. You know, and from there he had a vision. You know, along with his assistant coach, Mr. Keith Payne, who's been with him since he's been in position at Essex High School. IAD Coach Jones, our principal, Mr. Damon Bearfield, believed in Coach Jonathan Mercer's vision. And only thing Jonathan really needed was the girls.
Yep.
You know, it was the girls to buy into his vision.
Yep.
Which we see now they have.
Yep.
You know, that first year it was a little rocky. I think they went fourth in district. They went fourth in district and eighth in the region. The second year they came back, you know, they went second in district, third in region. Hey, lo and behold, this year, they first in the region.
They're first in everything.
First in district. You know, they're led by a bunch of seniors and Jayla Mercer, Kimar Gray, Miss Holmes. Uh-huh. They don't just have seniors on the team. They got juniors and sophomores that's putting up big numbers. And Miss Megan, Morgan Self, she's getting double-doubles, triple-doubles every other bag on day. Double digits in rebounds and blocks and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So she's only a junior, you know. So yeah,
she got another year. Goodness.
Well, I think, matter of fact, she's a sophomore. She got two more
years. She got two more years.
So that,
goodness
so
me.
So be led by the seniors, Jayla Mercer, Kimala Gray, and stuff like that, and still have those younger kids that's coming up, being able to put up big numbers that they're doing. It's only going to be better for the future.
Yeah,
not only Morgan Self, but Amani Brown. I think her name is McCarron Williams. Mm-hmm. Young ladies, if I mess up your name, please don't hold against me. You know, I'm just older than y'all. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, they're really pulling together this year and got the whole town behind them.
Yeah,
You thought that the support was from the boys was something. Well, with
you
those girls, we haven't seen our girls get this far like this in a long time. I think we haven't been this far, had a record like this since, like, early 2006.
Right, yeah.
So to see them be where they at now and to know where they came from, know the struggles that they had to pull through, the constant off-season workouts.
Right, yeah.
You know, stuff like that, because Jonathan been real heavy with them girls. Once the season's over, hey, they just like our legs to do them.
Yeah.
In the AAU circuit after the off-season, well, guess what? Our girls have been in the AAU circuit during the off-season, getting better. Constantly working together, learning schemes, learning their plays that the coach is drawing up and everything like that. And not just that, but they're listening. They're paying attention to what their coaches are saying and putting it to good use on the basketball court. You know, the last two games, you figure they played, on the 25th, they played Rappahannock, which was a real good game.
Real good game.
Real good game. Rappahannock gave them all they had. Mm-hmm. Rappahannock gave them all they had, like I said. Mm-hmm. The young lady over there, Rappahannock, I can't remember her name, Coleman, but she had a big game over there. She put up 23 points. Mm-hmm. So they was biting at us. But Jayla Mercer, she came up big in the fourth quarter, put up a big 10 points to be able to take the game over and everything. But the other scoring leaders in that game, Morgan Self, she had 4 points, but she had 8 rebounds, 3 blocks. Kimara Gray, she had 10 points, 13 rebounds. Uh-huh. And for her, of her size and structure, you wouldn't even think she would be able to get rebounds like that, because she's not that a big of a girl, but she's feisty, and she gets at it, and she's been hungry the last couple of years. I think last year she had an injury that set her down for a little while, and it's her last year. So she's coming back real hungry to prove a point in the winning
game. Yeah.
Amani Brown, 5 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, 4 steals. Jayla Mercer, like I said, she's the spearhead.
Right.
She's the point guard. She's the one that gets everything going. She put up a big 30 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and also had 6 steals on top of that.
Goodness, you know,
they was able to,
man.
They was able to capitalize off of Rappahannock's turnovers in that game. They made 12 points off of Rappahannock's turnovers. You know, then they come back on the 27th. They played Colonial Beach. Another good game. Morgan Self had 18 points. She had 18 points on that game. 21 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 steals, and 7 blocks for a sophomore. They got two more years left to make some noise.
What
you gotta do. So it's gonna be lovely for the next couple of years,
it's
man.
It's
gonna be. Amani Brown had 4.6 rebounds, 5 steals. You know, so I don't see nobody in the Northern Neck taking them out.
I don't either.
You know, they,
I really I don't
they
either.
They got two more games left, if I'm not mistaken. Which, matter of fact, They're playing tonight. They play Colonial Beach tonight.
Yeah, they are playing Colonial Beach tonight. Around probably around about maybe five. I believe that game was tip off was about around about 7 o'clock. So
if anybody got any updates, let us know. We'll get them out there.
And put
shout outs out there. But they're facing Colonial Beach tonight. They already beat them one time. They already beat them one time in the season. So I don't think it's going to be anything to stop them from that. And the other teams that they have that's coming up, I don't see nobody slowing them down.
No, not at all.
Picking up around
here. Yes, it is. Definitely.
Westmoreland, they won districts this year. I think they had a lot of players from over Lancaster that did good in wrestling. I know we had a few in Essex and everything. I know last week we had our senior night in Essex. And the boys over here, they did damn good.
Yes, they did.
You know, they represented for the purple and gold over here last week. I think they, it was January 24th, and they beat Northumberland last week. I guess 36-30. Then they turned around and beat King and Queen 48-30.
Goodness.
Eventually, like you say, Westmoreland is the district champ. They lost to Westmoreland in I think it was 54-36. But I mean, other than that, they smoked Northside, they smoked King Queen. King Queen just took a loss to Westmoreland. But like you say, individuals will have those next week.
Yeah, so you got the individuals, you got the teams.
Yeah.
Both Westmoreland and Essex are headed to the regionals.
Yeah.
So it's not over for Essex yet.
Yeah.
Coach Orlando Washington is doing good with that program right now.
Yep, Coach Jacob.
So,
Coach Jacob Young.
Yeah, Coach Jacob and Coach Orlando doing well.
Yes,
doing
sir.
Well
yes, sir.
With that program. So I can't wait to see what they do in the coming weeks. Not only Essex but Westmoreland too, and on the girls and boys side.
I think the district starts for wrestling on the 3rd. If I'm
not regional starts for wrestling.
Regional starts on the 3rd. I think it's going to be over at Lancaster High School. So. You know, if you're in the area, slide on over to Lancaster High School. I don't know the times right offhand right now, but I know it's February 3rd that regional starts off at Lancaster.
And that's going to be a good one because you're going to have Lancaster, Essex, Westmoreland going at it again. Yeah. And Lancaster has a good program over there, too, for wrestling. All right, Showtime MMA Academy. Showtime MMA Academy from Warsaw, Virginia. Well, this past weekend, they were at the World Fighting Championships, Coach. Mario Super Smash Ramirez wins it by unanimous decision. And Mike War Jones, a TKO in the second round. So Showtime MMA Academy goes home from the World Fighting Championships 2-0, starting out 2024. Ohio, I believe. Yeah, they were all the way out in Ohio. It was either Ohio or Michigan, I can't remember. But they come back 2-0 from that tournament. So
that's dope.
That's
and that's gonna be definitely good for them being in Warsaw for the kids that's coming out of high school, whatever like that. I mean, if you don't go to college wrestle, you still can be able to do what you gotta do.
Yeah.
If you got the heart for it. Because that MMA stuff is something way different.
Something different.
You know, I'd rather fight for real. I mean, I know they fight for real, but man, I can't see me sitting there getting punched in my face and all that stuff like that. But I don't know. But salute to them boys, man, going out there handling their business and bringing them trophies back to the Northern Network.
Yeah.
Really proud of y'all, fellas.
And Showtime MMA Academy, Mike Moore Jones, one win, and Mario Ramirez, one win. So, shine the light, Coach. We're at the shine the light segment. So, if you want to shine the light, give us a call if you want to shine a light on your favorite coach, player, or what have you. Yes, shine a light and give us a call.
Yes, sir. Right now for shine a light this week, I got three special players that I want to shine a light on through the Northern Neck. One female over here in Essex. Got a young man over there in Lancaster High School and a young man from Westmoreland High School. The first one up for me, though, like I was speaking about her earlier.
Yeah.
She's a sophomore over here, number 10, Morgan Self. The young lady's been dominant this year on the basketball court, man. She plays center. She's you go out there to the basketball game, she's one of the tallest ones out there. She's a young lady, but she's physical on that basketball court, man. Right now she's averaging about 11.5 points per game, 14.4 rebounds per game. She got 2.4 steals per game, 5.5 blocks per game, 47% from the free throw line. Right now, she has a total of 126 points this season with multiple double and triple doubles. She got a total of 158 rebounds this season. 61 total blocks. She got 26 total steals. She is also ranked number 7 in Virginia Class 1A.
Yeah.
And she's ranked number 7 in rebounds in Virginia Class 1. She's also ranked number 2 in blocks. And like I said earlier, man, she's only a sophomore. I can't wait to see
what she does in junior senior year.
She's only gonna get bigger, stronger. The coaches are only gonna make her work even harder during the off season. Her mother stays on her. Her father stays on her. They're very intertwined with her life and everything to try to help her get to the next level of what she wants to do. And I just want to shine a light on you, young lady. We always look at the top one, but man, we also got to look at the ones that's younger coming up to see what the future's like.
Definitely.
And she's going to be one of those ones that's going to help to lead that program once the Jayla Mercer's leave, once Kimar Gray leaves, and everything like that, because she's already had that taste of winning.
Yeah.
So regardless if those seniors that's there this year leaves and go on to college, which I know they're going to do, next year when she comes out, she's going to be the one that's going to be the leader on that team and want to stamp to be like Essex basketball. Essex girls basketball here to stay. As long as the coaches is there and they continue to follow the path of what the coaches want to do, I see her doing big things in the next 2 years. Because like I say, she's not no timid little girl. She's not your average little girl that we're pushing. She's getting in the paint, banging on you, getting 15 rebounds, man. It ain't too many girls going to be wanting to get up in that middle and bang with you and getting them rebounds and stuff like that, getting big blocks during the game, putting up, getting second chance points, getting rebounds for the team to create.
That's what it's all about, really. You got to get in.
Yeah, you got to get in there. And she's doing that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you're right, Jazz. Ain't too many boys trying to get banging that hole like that. They wanna hang around the 3-point line, shoot threes, hoping that the ball bounce back to you and everything. No, she down in that paint, man, banging, getting rebounds, putting.
That's how you win games. That's how you win games. 2 points. She could make a difference.
She's putting fear in a lot of girls' hearts, man, when they come in that paint, man. So Morgan, keep on doing your thing.
Yes, indeed.
We salute you big time over here at Northern Next Sports Talk Live. And young lady, I swear I can't wait to see what you do in the next 2 years. Put it like this. My homeboy Buck and my homegirl Tisha, they was at my house the other day. We was outside talking. Tisha was like, man, I ain't never seen no girl with a high arch like she did in the basketball games. We just chilling in the yard. And this another female that used to play for Essex back in the day when there was a dog on the basketball court. She's talking about this young lady like it's refreshing seeing her play out there.
Yeah,
like,
definitely.
You know what I'm saying? It's refreshing seeing Jayla Mercer play like that out there because we haven't had that in a long time.
Yeah.
So it's a big salute to you young ladies over there.
I wonder if we're going to wind up seeing her dunk more in the game.
I don't know where, man.
I want to see that.
But I would like for them to be able to lower the daggone goals for the girls, man.
Yeah.
Just like they talking about in the WNBA and stuff like that, it makes it more exciting.
Yeah,
like,
it does.
Just imagine you see a junior female go down and try a yank on enough. Man, what?
Yeah.
Man, the whole daggone crowd go crazy.
Yeah,
man, you know? So,
I
would love to see them lower the goal just about an inch or a couple of inches or whatever, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, you're talking about spending a whole lot of money there, which Essex High School and all these other high schools right here don't got, you know what I'm saying? But, again, Morgan Self, we want to salute you, baby girl. Shine the light on you. Keep on balling hard. Keep on doing what you're doing. Not just on the basketball field, but in the classroom, too, because at the end of the day, the class is the most important thing. Salute. Another one is Junior. Troy Henderson over at NNK High School. We was just talking about him. Me and Sammy was talking the other day. Sammy thought that he was a senior. We thought he was a senior. And I talked to the coach. I was like, man, Troy senior this year? He like, nah, man, he's a junior. Damn. And I mean,
imagine what he's going to do next year.
It's crazy, man. Like I said,
he's already lighting up the school boards everywhere.
Everywhere.
Imagine what he's going to do in his senior year.
It's only up, man. He's got plenty of offers coming in right now. So one more year, what he's doing this year, I'm pretty sure bigger schools is gonna start knocking at his door. Yeah, if they haven't already started knocking at his door. You figure Troy, he continued from last year putting up big numbers. So the Young Soldier so far total from once he stepped foot on the high school basketball court, he has 1,641 points.
Ooh-wee.
He already broke the Lancaster school record over there.
Yes,
so
he
right
did.
Now, all only things he's doing is putting up more numbers and more numbers to make it that
hard. Having them stats. That's all he's doing.
And whoever come behind him is like it's going to be impossible for them to break them numbers once they get up there. Before said and done, the young man's going to he's going to set the record so high that Mike can't be broken. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Right now, he's getting 25.5 points per game, 40% from the field goal. He's 4.7 rebounds per game, 3.4 assists per game, 81% from the free throw line, which is, you don't even got NBA college players that good from the free throw line like that. So it's good that he's able to knock them free throws down like that because they're free throws.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody calling.
Right.
You right there, so you should be able to knock them down. From the three, he's 36% from the 3-point line. This year, for this season, he has a total of 280 points this year, 37 assists, 52 rebounds. He's number two in class 1A for scoring.
Goodness.
You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, he's another one. He has one more whole year to go. So, it's only up for him.
It's going to be a very impressive year.
His name has been ringing through this whole area in the state of Virginia for the last couple
years. Yeah, it has. Yeah.
So, I mean, he's another one that everybody got to keep a watch on to be able to be playing at the next level. Another soldier is from over your way.
Darren Fauntleroy.
Darren Fauntleroy.
Yes.
A senior.
You see this, right? Yeah. See this, right?
Yeah, we see him. We're coming on up. But Darren Fauntleroy, a senior from over there. Westmore, I want to shine a light on you, young soldier. Broke a scoring record over there at Westmoreland last week against Colonial Beach. Young Soldier put up 49 points, 13 rebounds, 5 assists, 3 steals.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even recall nobody else even around here putting up those big.
Albert Haskins did it back in 1998 when Westmoreland won the championship.
So he broke his record.
Yeah, I believe he broke his record. I'm not for certain of numbers. Sammy will probably tell you the numbers.
Single game scoring record.
Yeah, single game scoring record from Albert Haskins. So we got to get into those numbers next week as to if he's close or not.
You from over there, so you got to find him. Will.
Yeah, I got to find him.
You're right. Get the trace, man, and get them numbers, man, so we can see who we beat, man.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
But other than that, man, that's all I got for Shine Light, man, you know.
Awesome.
All of y'all student athletes, man, y'all keep on grinding, keep on playing hard, listening to your coaches. Not only just that, man, keep on grinding in the classroom, because at the end of the day, if you ain't right in the classroom, it don't matter what you've done on the basketball court, coach is going to look right on past you. So grind in the classroom, keep on doing your work, listening to your coaches, man, and we're definitely looking to see y'all playing at the next level.
All right, Coach, let's get to the NFL real quick. AFC, NFC Championship. Did anything surprise you over the weekend?
Man, damn right it surprised me. Because the people that won, I didn't pick them to win. The people that won, I did not pick them to win. I did not expect Lamar to lose.
Right.
You know, I was banking on Lamar to win because even though I'm not a Baltimore, I'm a Baltimore fan because I just like...
It's kind of close to home.
Yeah, it's close to home. And you know, they ain't the Redskins. I just like Baltimore because they're a hard-nosed team.
Right.
I like how Coach John Harbaugh coaches them.
Yeah.
I like the aggressiveness style that they play ever since.
Yeah.
Ever since Ray Lewis and Ed Reed and all them boys like that, I just like Baltimore.
Yeah.
I love the city. Me and my wife goes to the visitor every now and then. It's a good city to have fun in. I just like the environment in Baltimore. So, last week I picked Baltimore to win. But I did not expect Lamar to go out there and play.
I didn't expect that either. I was expecting a very, very, I mean, it was a close game, honestly, but I was expecting the Ravens to come on top.
I expected Lamar to use his legs. That's what I expected. To me, I felt like Lamar was trying to play towards the critics. of them saying that he's not a pocket passer mm-hmm. or anything like that. But at this game right here, I'm using all my guards.
All options.
I'm using my arm, my legs. That one run where he, I think it was like fourth or something or third or something, yeah. And he broke through that. I thought it was gone.
Yeah.
Ain't no.
It was a good hole too.
The runs I didn't seen him break throughout the tenor of him being in the NFL, that looked like that could have been a house call from
yeah,
him. Ain't no reason why that safety or cornerback should have been able to pull him back down. It looked like he stopped and just gave himself up.
Yeah.
Instead of just going all out trying to get to that pile line and get the dang on touchdown. You figure in that game, first quarter was 7-7.
Uh-huh.
You know, then next thing you know, Kansas City scored 10 points in the second half. Ravens ain't scored nothing. You know what I'm saying? So, and then after that, the Ravens defense did their job.
Yes, they did. They definitely
Kansas City
did the job.
Didn't score no more.
Had Taylor Swift on the edge of her seat.
I'm tired of Taylor Swift. I'm looking at the damn game every day. Panning back Taylor Swift.
Hey, she's going to the Super Bowl.
They didn't do all that dang old stuff for Sierra, for Russell Wilson. Hey. And Sierra, I'll take Sierra over there.
Yeah, you're Swift. Right. Yeah, I agree with her.
Now, because of Taylor Swift, they want Pan and all this stuff, and she done made all this. Man, what the world? She needs to tell Taylor at home. Get her dad gonna kill
just
that
keep singing.
Yeah, just keep singing. but again, you know, Kelsey went crazy in that game.
Yes, he did.
11 targets, 11 receptions. I think he had like, what he had? 116 yards and a mm-hmm. touchdown. He went crazy the first half. Pat Mahomes, 30 for 39. 241 yards, one touchdown. The big thing, no interceptions, no fumbles. You know, as long as you don't do no stuff like that, you can come out on top. To me, I feel like Lamar didn't play to his full potential because he didn't use his legs. I feel like if he would have used his legs more, that game would have been over.
Right.
You know, he had 8 attempts rushing for 54 yards. Edwards had 3 attempts, only 20 yards. Ain't nobody else helped on the run. And I mean, their biggest attribute this year was the run game.
Yeah.
The run game sets up the play action off the pass and everything like that. It opens everything up. OBJ wasn't used. Only Zay Flowers, he had 5 receptions. He had a good game, 115 yards. Yeah. But he also had a big damn penalty and a big drop, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's little things like that. Aguilar, he really wasn't there. So, I mean, I really think the Ravens dropped the ball on this one.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like Kansas City was on a mission.
Yeah.
Because they never had to go on the road in the postseason.
No.
All through the postseason,
they
was at home. So for them to be able to go through the postseason, beat Buffalo, beat the Ravens, oh man, it's going to be real hard for anybody on the NFC side to even take them out. Now, as far as the NFC side, again, you know, I picked Detroit. To win because I liked it the storyline that we're building up with Detroit.
And that was a darn good high scoring game too.
Man, but it shouldn't have even been like that.
It shouldn't have been like that.
Detroit jumped up 24-7 at halftime, man. Ain't no way in the world.
Yeah, how do you come back to a championship game?
Because the coach got out of doing what he was doing in the first half. Run it dang on ball, man. Run the clock out.
Yeah.
But no, you coming out after the end of the second half, you're throwing the ball. You're not running the ball. How many interceptions did go? He didn't throw no interceptions, but I think they had one fumble loss, which really didn't hurt him and everything. But then next thing you know, your defense, like, they just gave up.
Right, yeah.
You know, and then, I mean, field goals. You're going on fourth down, not cashing in on the fourth downs. You left points on the board and everything like that.
Yeah, you got to be smart with the play call.
You got to be smart.
Against 49ers.
And everybody that was talking about Purdy, man, Purdy's showing everybody that he's a top-grade QB himself.
Yeah.
He was drafted in the last round, but he's playing like a first-rounder to me.
Yes, he is.
You know, Purdy went 20 for 30, 167 yards, one touchdown, one interception. But what I liked about Purdy that Lamar didn't do, Purdy used his legs.
He used his legs. He definitely used his legs.
He picked up some big first downs off of his legs. And if he wouldn't have done that, the game would have
won. And he looked downfield the whole entire time. He was looking downfield.
He was looking one click, two click, it ain't there, I'm gone. Picked up first down, big first downs. So in games like that, you got to do those types of things to be able to come out on top. And unfortunately, you know, Kyle Shanahan and them, they dialed it up in the second half. And unfortunately, Lions went back home packing. You know, they went back to Detroit with their tails tucked to their legs.
Did you hear what one Lions fan did?
Yeah.
Permanent prediction gone wrong.
What is that?
Permanent prediction gone wrong. He gets a tattoo in August during preseason, tattooed on his arm, Super Bowl 58 champions, Detroit Lions.
Wish. Well, I've seen plenty of dumb daggone Cowboys fans to get tattoos that year saying we going Super Bowl, then they look like asses at the end of the day. Don't do nothing like that. I'm a diehard Cowboy. I wish I would go and get a tattoo saying we going to Super Bowl this year. And then next thing you know, dang, I got
they lose the NFC Championship.
The dumbest dang old thing ever.
All right, so that sets us up to Super Bowl 58, folks. San Francisco 49ers and the Kansas City Chiefs. Basically, Kansas City Chiefs plus Taylor Swift and the San Francisco 49ers.
Yes, sir.
So who you got?
Well, I mean, we just got to wait till next week's show, but, you know.
We come back next week.
And talk about the Super Bowl since it's next week. We talk about these games, basketball, these good basketball games coming up, and we talk about the Super Bowl. So, in order for y'all to know what my pick is, man, y'all got to tune back in with us next week.
You do. Coach, any final thoughts before we head out?
Man, like I say, man, like 2024 came in with a vengeance with a lot of folks, man, you know, they're swinging, so... Today, mainly the coaches. What you used to say? Coaches.
When you win, you win. You lose, you learn.
No, man. When I say my things at the end of the show.
The coach's corner.
Yeah, coach's corner. So this is for us adults.
Yeah.
Keep pushing. This is for us adults today. Keep pushing. Whenever things feel like it's going wrong or problems coming in your way and you feel them down, this is for us. Keep pushing. Because regardless of the fact, life is going to always life.
Yeah.
You know, as long as the good Lord up above wake you up that next day, you always got a day to
correct
whatever happened the day before. Don't be looking in the past. Keep looking towards the future, man. Everything going to be all right.
Episode 50. Next week, you heard right. Episode 50 of Northern Neck Sports Talk Live, and next week, guys, thank you so much for getting us here. It was because of you. It is because we are at episode 50 next week. And by the way, No Next Sports Talk Live in 2022, 2023, top 10% shared globally.
Okay.
And in 2024, nationally nominated for Communicator Awards.
Hey, that's lovely, man.
Like, that is.
I don't even be seeing you be on it. Y'all are looking at them stats and stuff, man. But hey, that's all because of y'all, man. We
yes,
see
indeed.
All of y'all, you know, we do this for the area. We do this trying to shine a light on these youngers around here that's coming up in this area, because at the end of the day, they are our future. You know, a lot of us played the sports and everything like that, but because of grades or making the wrong decisions when we was younger, we wasn't able to go as far as these kids that's coming up now. But, you know, a lot of us learned from our mistakes, so now we're trying to push these kids in a better direction, man. So, you know, salute to y'all. Keep on supporting us, and we're going to keep on trying to bring the news of the youth in the Northern Neck to everybody.
And make sure you follow us on Northern Neck Sports Talk Live on Facebook, and we'll talk to you next week on episode 50 here on Northern Neck Sports Talk Live. For myself, Coach Thomas Roane, John Scott, and T. Harris, we bid you good night from Tappahannock, Virginia.
Hey, man, you ain't Coach Thomas?
Yeah, this is Coach Thomas Roane. I said Coach Thomas Roane.
Okay.
So for myself, Coach Thomas Roane, Giles Scott, T. Harris, and Sammy Mills, we bid you good night from Tappahannock, Virginia. No Next Sports Talk Live on Hot Mix VA.